Good day, and welcome to Feed Dump, where all the worthwhile news is thrown out with the trash. I'm Graham. Joining me this week, Paul.
Hi.
And Matt.
Hello.
So let's get to our nudes. And now, a delightful story from New Zealand, where a man tried to escape police custody in a hospital by getting naked and hiding in the ceiling.
Finally, a story from New Zealand involving nudity, but not a sheep.
We don't know what he was being arrested for. Also, he was naked up in the ceiling of the hospital, and we don't know what he had with him.
I tell you what we do know, that it took a 7-hour manhunt, a fire brigade, and a specialist search team with thermal imaging equipment to find him in the ceiling just a little bit over from where he initially crawled in.
That is the makings of a porn movie right there.
Hey, baby. Do you need anything thermally imaged?
Bounch, wow, wow.
So I understand you need me to crawl up in your ceiling.
Bounch, wow, wow.
Well, since he's gone missing, I guess there's an opening for a naked man.
Bounch, wow, wow.
I'll give you a 7-hour manhunt.
The police in Southampton... The city police of Southampton, England, scrambled their helicopters and got their tranquilizer guns ready after the report of an escaped white albino tiger. Upon further inspection, it was a life-size stuffed toy. They maybe could have guessed that, because how many white albino tigers are there in England, I mean, really?
I don't think I'd be a very good animal control guy, because when I hear that there's a white albino tiger escaped on the golf course, my first question is, where did it escape from? And are there more white albino tigers there that we should worry about?
The toy is now being treated by the police as lost property, but I think the owner knows exactly where it is.
Oh, come on! I can't be asked to account for every single one of my giant albino white tiger stuffed animals! I mean, they could be anywhere!
4 people were hospitalized, and presumably the nation of Italy embarrassed, when a dispute over the thickness of supermarket ham slices turned violent.
I said a quarter of an inch, not 2/8. 2/8 is too thick.
All right, you know what? Let's just compromise and do 4/16.
And more delightful wording from the Free Press. The shop assistant, the disgruntled ham shopper, and her husband all suffered bruises.
These are all porn scenarios.
Hey, baby, I'm a disgruntled ham shopper.
Bounch, wow, wow.
Don't worry, baby. My ham ain't sliced too thick. It's just right.
Just to be clear, you're talking about your penis, right?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
And now for a segment I'm improbably calling Paul and Matt Have to Figure Out What I'm Talking About.
Paul and Matt have to figure out what Graham is talking about.
A woman from New Kensington, Pennsylvania has to stand trial after being accused of feeding a food laced with marijuana to a 12-year-old. What food?
The obvious answer is brownies.
But that seems too obvious. Otherwise, we wouldn't have to do that whole jingle and everything.
Nope.
Cookies?
Also no.
Baklava?
No.
Butter?
Pot stickers?
That was terrible. It is, in fact, margarine. Specifically, hidden in tubs of, I can't believe it's not butter.
That was a pretty, I feel like Fabio would back me up that was a pretty good guess.
You're so right, Paul. I couldn't believe it wasn't butter either.
Now, often in news stories, they will say something like, so-and-so is unavailable for comment, or so-and-so did not return our calls. I've never seen a story actually say, her home phone is disconnected. So, that was the news we felt like dumping on you this week. Until next time, remember, there may be better sources for news, but they don't have this hat.
Hey, baby. I'll dump on you.
Bound, wow, wow.
Wait.
You should probably just leave. That is maximum fan. It is on high, and it is barely moving my hair. Fabio must have had, because he had that thing in his contract that he had to have a fan on his hair. They must have been industrial strength fans.
You need like a wind machine.
Machine. This is useless. It is cooling, though.